I was very concerned. I was very torn about taking the role because I was a big fan of the book and I knew that it was dangerous playing a character who was not in the original book. But in the end, there were so many very important and good reasons to have this character in the film, and to, for me, I think that if any little girl can walk out of this movie theater and have watched this movie and found it relevant to her and felt like she was relevant to the story, because of course we put ourselves into these characters and the little girl's looking for the girl, she wants to connect to that character, then I've done my job. I think that in Tolkien's day, writing a book that didn't have any female characters was acceptable, but in this day and age it's not. And especially not a film that is designed to entertain children, because we're sending the messages through that film, and the last thing that we want to tell little girls is that they're irrelevant. I think that what Peter brings to these films is first his passion for fantastical worlds and creatures, and he has a very exciting vision, but I love the way he brings, I mean, I think on a certain level he's a little bit of a conservative. I look at some of the creations that Guillermo del Toro had created for this film when he was attached as the director, and for me they're too much of a departure from what I feel Tolkien described, and I feel like in that way Peter is a little bit of a conservative, and that serves him really well, because if you talk to most Tolkien fans, they say, well, every character that he created looks exactly how they looked in my mind. He's really stuck to the books and he's really been true to Tolkien's word. And then as an actor, he's so much fun. He's always laughing, he's always making jokes, he doesn't take himself seriously, and I value that to no end. I'm a Canadian, and I think that's one of the things that we're sort of do in Canada, is we make fun of ourselves and we don't take ourselves seriously, and so it was very relatable for me to have a director who could just laugh with me. I'm so glad that we shot them back to back the way we did, because in order to shoot and then go away and come back and shoot and go away and come back and shoot, it disjoins the performance, it disjoins your character development. Like everything that you sort of built up to play that character, it's a lot of energy to build it up in the first place. So to be able to carry on with it is nice. And then coming away from the experience, some of my best memories, for me, some of my best memories are, as boring as this might sound, having raised my son for his first year of life in New Zealand, and just the amount of time we spent in this beautiful seafront home, in this very simple, sweet community. New Zealand's culture is so innocent and so traditional, and is very family-oriented and community-oriented, and I felt like it was this little cocoon, and our family were able to sort of just sit in that little cocoon for my baby's first year, and that was such a gift. The hardest part was that I was only 3 months out from giving birth to my son when I started my stunt training, when I started working on the film. So not only was I doing wardrobe fittings and I was not looking like I normally look because I just had a baby, but I was also trying to do stunts and I couldn't move like I could normally move because my hips were still, you know, spread. And I couldn't think aggressively because I had all these happy hormones and estrogen floating through my brain. So it was really a challenge to go from mummy land to this aggressive, badass, kick-ass character. That was a massive challenge. I think that, of course, Tolkien always addresses the notion of good versus evil, and particularly in this film and with my character, the themes that I love, I really am excited that I get to explore through the character and bring into people's consciousness, is the idea of letting go of our prejudices, of accepting that we see the world one way, but other people might see it another way, and that's okay. Of fighting for truth and justice at all costs, at not putting personal aim before our ideals. She's a very noble character, and I'm very proud to play her. Oh man, there's so many. But I think two of them that stand out like in a big way for me from my experiences, from the Fellowship of the Rings, when the Ringwraiths first are sort of introduced, and Frodo is hiding under the embankment, and all of a sudden all the insects start to crawl out of the train, and then the black hooves go by, and you hear that screeching of the Ringwraiths. Oh man, not only was it terrifying as you wanted it to be, it was exactly how I imagined it from the book. And then the introduction of Galadriel, that was exactly how I pictured it in the book. And I'm really, I'm a little bit disappointed because one of the things that stood out for me the most in The Hobbit was the lights that flickered on and off and went on in the forest in Mirkwood when the dwarves were being led off of the path. And that's not how the elves are introduced in the film. And I really wanted to see that sort of celebratory, partying nature of the Sylvan elves in the film, which you don't get to see it as, in that way.